This is a conscious effort by BOLDT to become better at what we do, increase our margins, and become more competitive in the workspace. To stay competitive in the market, we have to make sure that we bring in as much of digital fabrication and modeling as we can to make sure that what the things we will eventually build in the safest manner with the highest quality and to the highest production rates possible. For framing, we have focused on bringing all the different pieces and stakeholders together so that we at BOLDT can really focus on delivering our project successfully.
With the modeling effort, we've discovered that it's allowed us to find nuances of design gaps and early on create a strategy of how we would actually solve those problems before it would be an issue or boots on the ground.
When performing the framing fabrication model, it's not only important to understand the architectural design in terms of wall configuration, but also to fully understand the framer specifications and preferences.
One of the things that this has really brought to light is that the framing component is generally forgotten about. With our early presence and design and modeling efforts, we're able to sit at the table with the rest of the trade partners.
The BIM coordination helps us in the field with other trades getting through some of our problems. My experiences with the modelers has been great. It's nice to see any conflict early. If we have any problems as we're going, they're very easy to communicate with, talk to, and we get quick responses on any problems that we might have in the field.
An enormous amount of clashes between MEP trades and kickers as well as kingstats can be prevented in order to avoid too many site adjustments and reinforcements.
ENGworks, our designers, have been able to sit through coordination meetings with the rest of the trade partners.
It's really simplifying things. We get all the proper information, and by looking around at the environment we're working in, clean, dry, you're not tripping over stuff. As opposed to in the field, especially during inclement weather and so forth, you got a good environment to work in.
And these efficiencies that we see overall really translate into cost savings in the end. We're experiencing less rework, and we're also experiencing less material waste as well as waste in manpower on site.
If you ask me what the keys of success are, I would say number one, precision, and number one as well, communication with the framer.
The BIM and modeling with their accuracy help us take that out into the field and be more productive.
We're on the same page. I mean, panels are coming down in a timely fashion. They're coming down stacked, nice, properly, easy to identify where they're going, what elevation they are.
I believe it's an easier way of doing it this way here. I believe moving forward is really going to be the way things have to come together.
I felt from the start that ENGworks has been a true partner. We've learned together with them and we have excelled together as well as we're growing into this journey on fabrication, prefabrication, and framing in general.